existing buildings, the dock edge may not have any type of embedded steel, or the steel may be poorly attached. It is still possible to install an edge of dock leveler using an approach plate. Visually inspect the leveler for possible damage or missing parts immediately upon receipt of the unit. If damaged or missing parts are noted, have the carrier personnel sign the bill of lading as damaged or that parts are missing. If necessary, prepare a claim against the carrier. The levelers are shipped banded without tension on the spring. Prior to installation, clean the dock face and area. Scrape the dock face, the vertical face of the dock, and the floor in order to make sure that there are no protrusions such as a bolt sticking out or excess concrete on either the floor or the face of the dock. At the dock edge, mark the center of the chosen leveler location. For 66-inch wide units, mark the dock edge 33 inches either side of the center. For 72-inch models, this mark would be 36 inches to either side. For 78-inch models, this mark would be 39 inches to either side. For 84-inch models, this mark would be 42 inches to either side. Place the approach plate on the floor flush with the front edge of the dock face. For approach plates with a bend along the rear, mark the floor along the back edge of the plate and then slide the plate forward a couple of inches. Cut a groove in the floor along the line previously marked. Move 2 inches toward the dock and cut a parallel line in the floor along the long dimension of the approach plate. Chip out the concrete between the two grooves. The groove should be 2 inches wide and 1/8 inch deeper than the thickness of the approach plate. If the approach plate is flat and beveled, no bend along the rear edge, do not cut a groove in the floor. Just place the plate on the floor with the leading edge flush with the dock face. Drill the holes in the floor using the holes in the approach plate as a guide. Install the anchor bolts through the plate and into the floor. Pioneer recommends 5/8 inch by 5 inch wedge anchors. After the wedge anchors are in place and the plate is bolted down securely, weld and grind the bolt heads down in order to allow for a smooth transition for the forklift. The leveler can be raised into position by forklift. Place the center plate and lip plate flat on the forks with the base plate hanging vertically and raise the leveler so that the base plate is flat to the face of the dock. Locate the top edge of the base plate approximately 1/8 inch below the top edge of the approach plate. Since it is very difficult to get the base plate perfectly level with the dock edge or approach plate, it is best to get one side in the proper location and tack weld the base plate to the approach plate. Raise the other side to the desired location and tack weld that side to the approach plate. One at a time, lift the bump block up to the dock edge, making sure that the top of the bump block is slightly below the top of the approach plate and that there is at least 1/4 inch space between the side flange of the bump block and the edge of the base plate. Tack weld the bump block to the approach plate. Repeat this step on the opposite side of the leveler. Continuous weld the bump blocks and base plate along the top and, if possible, on all vertical edges while making sure the leveler is firmly up against the dock. Drill holes into the dock face through the holes in the bump blocks and along the bottom of the base plate. The holes in both the base plate and the bump block are 13/16 inch in diameter. Insert the wedge anchors and tighten. On bar lift models, when the installation of the leveler and bumper is complete, remove the bolt from the lifting bar. Insert the bar into the bracket on the side of the leveler with the handle facing forward and reattach the bolt. After the installation is complete, adjust the tension as follows. Carefully raise the center plate and then the lip plate. Loosen the two set screws in the spring winding assembly, which is the square tube attached to the spring. Place an 1.5 inch open wrench or a large crescent wrench capable of opening at least 1.5 inches on the square tubing and rotate the tube toward you approximately 1/4 turn. While holding the wrench and tube firmly in this position, tighten the set screws. carefully close the unit. Do not let the unit fall free to the closed position. In the closed position, the center plate should ride slightly above the dock bumpers. Test the unit for lifting ease. If the unit seems hard to operate, repeat the previous adjustment steps. After the final adjustment, operate the unit several times just to make sure that everything is functional. As a final touch, spray paint the welds and any other areas that may need to be touched up due to the installation process.